The US EPA produced a document in 2010 saying we have to reduce bacteria coming out of Phillippi Creek watershed. And they said we need a 98% reduction. To do that, we're working with the state, the Florida Department of Environmental Protection, in a very cooperative, collaborative way. Their method for improving the watershed includes walking around and looking for sources of pollution. You put together a team of people and you look around the watershed and identify anything that can be fixed quickly, and then have a plan to deal with other pollution problems that you've identified during this process. The process is called Walk the Watershed, and we're really looking forward to it. We're just getting started with Walk the Watershed in Phillippi Creek. Two big efforts that Sarasota County's done are the Phillippi Creek Septic System Replacement Program and the Celery Fields Regional Stormwater Facility. They both make a big difference in water quality and protect our bays. The septic system program has now taken 8,000 septic systems and connected them to a modern central sewer, which is a much better way to manage our own wastewater. The celery fields improves the water quality of about 10% of the watershed. That's a big area. It's 1,300 acres that are improved in terms of water quality, and also protects homes from flooding in the watershed.
Phillippi Creek is the largest source of fresh water to the bay, and where fresh and salt water mix, they're the most important areas for the ecology that we have to offer in Florida. They're the most productive from a juvenile fish standpoint, oysters, all types of sea life in our region. And so we've been studying Phillippi Creek for quite a long time now. There's been great improvements in the creek. We've seen more than a 67% reduction in nitrogen pollution to this in this creek as a result of all the actions that Sarasota County has taken. Our recent Tidal Creek study has shown very good diversity and all different age classes of fish, which means this creek is offering a very productive habitat for all types of species.
And that provides some refuge from certain predators that fish are encountering out in the bay per se and offshore. So for many species, the tidal creeks serve as nursery grounds for them to grow up in and then move back out into the bay. Examples, red drum, tarpon, common snook, are all examples of fishes that benefit greatly from the tidal creeks.
A lot of things have been done to improve the creek, and government can only do so much. And it's up to each and every one of us to comply with standards like the fertilizer ordinances and to do things that are necessary to help protect this bay. You know, it's little things like not throwing your grass clippings in the gutter. Now, you know, direct your lawnmower have a mulching mower and direct it into your yard, because all those little things add up in producing nitrogen pollution to the bay. And when the grass clippings die, they release nitrogen. That nitrogen ends up here and could potentially create a pollution problem in our bay.
So in August, at August 31st, we're inviting the public to come and meet with us in a public meeting and talk about what they think the pollution sources are, where they think the pollution sources are. We'll have a meeting, it's called Maps on Table, and we have all these maps of the watershed with a lot of things mapped out, where the different sewer lines are, septics, things like that. And we ask people to mark up the maps and write notes down about, I think you should check here, I think you should check there. All of the places they mark, we will go out in the field as a team and look for evidence of pollution. One of the other things we do is we take all the water quality data, all the water samples we've paid for over the years in different organizations, we analyzed all that data and mapped that out too and say, well, here's a place where we see more bacteria than that other place. All of those get investigated. So it's a pretty common sense, straightforward field investigation based on any clue we can find to investigate. We're really eager to hear from the citizens, and the easy way to contact us is through the County Contact Center. The number is 861-5000.